Next, we will see the selection sort algorithm. So selection sort algorithm also sorts the array elements in ascending order. Now here we scan the entire array from left to right and we go on comparing the adjacent elements and we sort the array elements in ascending order. In bubble sort, at the end of each scan, the largest element bubbles out and is positioned in the last position of the array. That's why it's called bubble sort. In case of selection sort, at the end of each scan, the lowest element or the smallest element is placed in the first position of the array. After the second scan, the second smallest element is positioned in the second position of the sorted array. So, and also in case of bubble sort, we compare the adjacent elements and if they are out of order, then we swap it. Here, we scan the array and we find the minimum element or the lowest element and then swap the elements. So, we'll see one example here. So, 4, 3, 1, 2 are the contents of the array. So, now I assume that the first element itself is the minimum element and then I compare it with the adjacent element. Now, since 4 is greater than 3, so 3 is less than 4, so now I will assign 3 as the new minimum element and then I continue the comparison. Now, 3 I will compare it with 1. Since 1 is less than 3, so I found a new minimum element. So, 1 is now the new minimum element. I will compare it with 2, the next element in the array. So, since 1 is less than 2, so my minimum element is 1 itself and I have reached the end of the array. Now, I will swap it and move it to the first position in the array. So, I will now swap 1 and 4 and the smallest element 1 is now at the sorted position, that is at the first position in the sorted array. Now I will start the scanning starting from the second element of the array. Since now one element is already sorted, so I will start with the second element. Now again 3 and 4 I will compare. Since 3 is less than 4, so 3 itself is the new minimum element. So now 3 and next element, that is the last element of the array, I will compare. So 3 and 2 I will compare. Since 3 is greater than 2, so the new minimum element is 2. So now I will swap 2 and 3. So 2 moves to the second position in the array now. Now remaining elements I will have to sort. So again I will scan the array. Now I will compare 4 and 3, that is the remaining elements. Since 4 is greater than 3, so the new minimum element is 3 now. Now I will swap 3 and 4. So end of the third iteration, 3 and 4 is sorted. So now the entire array 1, 2, 3, 4, this is the array in ascending order. Note that comparison is same like the bubble sort, but swapping takes place at the end of the scan or at the end of each iteration. I'll just scan the array, compare the adjacent elements and find the new minimum element. At the end of the iteration, the new minimum element which is there, I'll sort it and swap it and place it in the appropriate position in the sorted array. Now we'll see the program here. Again, I and j for accessing the array, n is to specify the limit of the array, then A is the array I have declared over here. Again 10 I have given, so maximum 10 elements I can store in the array. Then temp is used for swapping purpose. Then one additional variable minimum here used to indicate the minimum element. So enter the array limit. Again I have taken array limit as 3. Then array elements I have inserted is 4, 1 and 2. Now before sorting, I'll just display the contents of the array here, making use of this particular for loop. Now we'll see the sorting here. So for I equal to 0, I is less than n minus 1, I plus plus. So now here outside for loop here specifies the number of times we will have to scan the array. Now 0 to n minus 1. So that means here now n I have taken it as 3. So I can run from 0, 1, n minus 1 becomes 3 minus 1, that is 2. So I can run from 0 and 1. So that is the limit we have given over here. Next, I have given minimum equal to I. Now we'll see the iterations here by taking the example. That is, now the example here, 4, 1, 2 are the contents of the array. So now for I equal to 0, I is less than n minus 1. N minus 1 is 3 minus 1, that is 2. So 0 is less than 2, condition is true. So control will come inside. Now minimum equal to I, that is the first element of the array, I will initialize it as, I will take it as minimum element. So minimum equal to I. I is 0, so minimum equal to 0. Now for j equal to I plus 1. Now I will compare this minimum element with the next element, adjacent element. So j is equal to I plus 1. Because after each scan, first, for example, after first scan, first element is sorted. So then I have to start with the second element. Second element will be assigned as minimum element, and I should compare it with the adjacent element, that is the third element. So that is why I have made it as I plus 1. So j equal to I plus 1. So 0 plus 1 is 1. So j is equal to 1 here. J is less than n. N is 3. So 1 is less than 3. Condition is true. So control will come inside. Now, if a of j is less than a of minimum, a of j is a of 0 is less than a of minimum. A of minimum is a of 0. So a of j is 1. So a of minimum is 0. So a of 1 is compared with the a of 0. So a of 0 the value is 4, a of 1 the value is 1. So now a of j is 1, 1 is less than 4. The condition is 1 is less than 4 is checked. Since 1 is less than 4, the condition is true. So now the new minimum element will be 1. So now minimum should point to this location. So that is why minimum equal to j. So minimum, now minimum value becomes 1. So and minimum points to the location 1. Now again control will come back here. J is incremented by 1. J was 1 is incremented, so j becomes 2. So 2 is less than 3, condition is true. So again control comes inside the for loop. Now this condition, a of j is less than a of minimum. Now a of j value is a of j value, new value of j is now 2. So a of 2 is less than a of minimum. Minimum value is now 1. Minimum is pointing here. So now a of 1. So a of j is a of 2. A of minimum is a of 1. So a of 2 the value is 2. A of minimum the value is 1. So now 2 is less than 1. The condition is checked is 2 is less than 1. Since the condition is false, so the control will again move back here. This if part is not executed, so control will come back here. J is incremented by 1. J becomes now, j was 2, j becomes now 3. So 3 is less than 3. 3 is less than 3, condition is false. So control will go outside this for loop, that is will directly come to this part. Now if minimum is not equal to I, now I am checking whether the first initially I have mentioned the value, minimum value assigned it to I. So I am checking whether the first value itself was minimum or not. Now I have found a new minimum value. So now minimum is not equal to I. Minimum is pointing here. Minimum value is, value of minimum is 1. So I value is 0. So 1 is not equal to 0. Condition is true. So now I have to swap this element 1 with the first element. So temp equal to a of i is a of 0, the value is 4, is moved to temp. Now a of i equal to a of minimum. So A of 0 equal to A of 1. A of 0 the location, the value to be moved is A of minimum, that is A of 1, the value is 1. So 1 is moved to this position, and value 4 is in temp, it is moved to A of minimum position, that is A of 1. So 1 and 4 are swapped now. Now this order it is 1, 4, 2. Now again control will now come back here. So I is incremented by 1. So now first iteration is over. Now I is incremented by 1. I was 0, I becomes 1 now. 1 is less than n minus 1. N minus 1 is 3 minus 1, 2. So 1 is less than 2 condition is true. Now minimum equal to I. So minimum equal to 1. So now minimum is pointing here at location 1. So now for j equal to I plus 1. So j equal to I plus 1. So I is 1. So 1 plus 1, 2. So j will be pointing here. So j equal to 2. So 2 is less than n is 3. So 2 is less than 3 is true. So condition is true. So control will come inside the for loop. A of j is less than A of minimum. A of j is A of 2 less than A of minimum. A of minimum. Minimum value now is 1. So A of 1. So A of j is, the value is 2. A of minimum, the value is 4. So 4 and 2 are compared. So 2 is less than 4. The condition is checked. 2 is less than 4. The condition is true. So minimum equal to j. So now minimum equal to j. So this is the new minimum value. So minimum will point here. So minimum equal to 2. So minimum will be pointing here now. Now control will come back here. J is incremented by 1. J was 2. J becomes 3. Now 3 is less than 3 condition is false. So it will directly come outside the for loop, that is here, outside the inner for loop. So now minimum is not equal to I. So minimum is not equal to I, that is minimum is 2 now. I value is 1 now. So 2 is not equal to 1. Condition is true. So temp equal to A of I. A of I is A of 1, the value stored is 4, that is moved to temp, and then A of I, that is A of 1 equal to A of minimum. A of minimum is A of 2, the value stored is 2 here, 2 is moved to A of I position, that is second position. Then whatever value was there in temp will be moved to this position where minimum is pointing, that is minimum is A of 2 here. So temp we have moved the value 4. So 2 and 4 are swapped now. So now control will come back here. I is incremented by 1. I was 1. I becomes 2 now. 2 is less than n minus 1 is 3. So 2 is less than 2. Condition is false. So now the array is already sorted. So condition becomes false. So the control will directly come outside the outer for loop and will execute the next instruction. Now the array is sorted. We have to display the sorted array. So I made use of this for loop to display the sorted array element. I use slash t so that one of the array elements after sorting are displayed with the tab space. 1, 2 and 4 is the sorted array will be displayed here. So execute the program and see whether you get the proper output.